We like to think of Canada warblers as birds of the boreal forest, and they are. But Canada warblers go south for the winter, all the way to northern South America. Very soon, they're going to be headed back to their boreal forest breeding grounds. We're following the Canada warbler as it heads back to the boreal, along with billions of other birds. Our first stop is the Andes Mountains in Colombia.
Do many people or bird watchers in Colombia know about the boreal forest, where they're headed?
When I tell the people that these little tiny birds can fly from Canada through here and they must get back in order to reproduce themselves, and they do it like every year, the people go like, wow.
Hi, my name is Daniel Escobar and I live in La Semilla, a natural reserve located in the municipality of Finlandia, Quindío, Colombia, South America.
The Canada warbler, locally we call it La Reinita del Canadá. Canada warbler have been recorded between 1,500 meters and 2,400 meters above the sea level, mainly in the Andean regions. In La Semilla, we designated close to the 90% of the total area for the conservation of the migratory and local birds. And here they can find seeds, fruits, insects, and everything the birds needed for their survival.
Well, the boreal forest are very important for the warblers in order to accomplish the life cycle. You have to prevent all the threats, the boreal forest, and here in the tropical forest also.
Canada warbler is just one example of the birds that connect places across the hemisphere. That means that conserving the boreal forest means supporting ecosystems as far away as South America and vice versa. We'll check in on the Canada warbler as it makes its way north. Follow boreal conservation to see where they end up next.